Hello friends, this video on NEET Electromagnetic Induction is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Question number 10. A wire of length 1 meter is moving at a speed of 2 meter per second. So velocity is given, length is also given. Perpendicular to its length in a homogeneous magnetic field of 0.5 tesla. So B is also given. If the ends of the wire are joined to a circuit of resistance 6 ohms, then the rate at which work is being done to keep the wire moving at constant speed is. So here also, first of all, we will find out the induced EMF. So induced EMF is equal to B cross V into L. So B cross V will be B V sine theta into L. So theta will be 90 degrees. So this will be B V L. So B is given as 0.5, V is given as 2, L is given as 1. So this will be equal to 1 volt. This is induced EMF. Now resistance is given as 6 ohm. Now we have to find out the rate at which work is done. So rate of work done is nothing but power. So we know that power is equal to V square by R. So induced EMF square by R. That will be equal to 1 into 1 divided by 6 or 1 by 6 watt. So C is the right option. Question number 11. A thin semicircular conducting ring PQR of radius R is falling with its plane vertical in a horizontal magnetic field B as shown in the figure. The potential difference developed across the ring when its speed is V is. Okay, now if the conductor is moved instead of the magnetic field, in that case motional EMF is induced. That's what we know, right? So when the conductor is moving in a magnetic field, then it is the concept of motional EMF. And motional EMF is equal to B cross V into L. That is equal to B V sine theta into L. So sine theta in this case will be 1 because theta is 90 degree. As you can see here, because the ring is falling vertical and the magnetic field is horizontal, which shows that the angle between them is equal to 90 degree. Now, what is the value of B? So B will be B. V will again remain as V. And what is the L? So what will be the value of L? So L is basically the distance between the two ends. That is this distance. So this will be equal to 2 times the radius. So this will be 2R. So this will be 2BVR. So this will be the value of induced EMF. So the correct option is D. Question number 13. The current I in a coil varies with time as shown in the figure. The variation of induced EMF with time would be. So this is the figure which is given in the question. And these are the four options A, B, C, D. Okay. So now let us look at the three parts of the figure. This is part 1, this is part 2, and this is part 3. Three parts of the graph. Now we already know that phi is equal to Li. We also know that minus d phi by dt is equal to minus L di by dt. Therefore, we know that induced EMF is equal to minus L di by dt. Right? So here the variation of current with time is given. And here it talks about the induced EMF. So let us look at the first part. So in part 1, what is happening? We see that the current changes from 0 to this value, but it has a constant slope, right? Which means that di by dt is equal to constant in first part of the graph, in this part, right? Di by dt. So di by dt is basically the slope. So slope is tan theta. So the slope is constant. So if di by dt is constant, then E will be what? E will be constant, but it will be negative constant, right? So this would, E would be negative constant. Now let's look at the second part of the figure. In the second part of the figure, we see that I itself is constant. Now since current itself is constant, that means di by dt is equal to 0 because the current is not changing with time. Therefore, E will be equal to 0. And what is happening in the third part of the graph? So there again, we see that the slope is constant, but it is negative constant. So in this case, di by dt is constant but negative constant. Therefore, the EMF will be constant, but it will be positive constant. Right? So because here the value might be the same, but the directions are changing. So now looking at these values, we can find out which is the correct one. So if you look at option one, so for the first half, it is increasing. But for us, the first half should have been constant. So this is not correct. In option B, the first half again is it is changing, but we want it to be constant. In option C, the first half is constant but positive. So this is also not correct. We want the first half to be constant and negative. So this is correct. Now, if you tally this, first half is positive, negative constant, second half is zero, and third half is constant but positive. So this is the correct option. Question number 14. A circular disc of radius 0.2 meters is placed in a uniform magnetic field of induction 1 by pi Weber per meter square in such a way that its axis makes an angle of 60 degree with B. The magnetic flux linked with this disc is. So magnetic flux is equal to B dot A, that is B A cos theta. Now in this case, area of the disc is equal to pi R square, that is pi into 0.2 whole square, right? So therefore, the value of phi will be equal to B, that is 1 by pi into A, that is pi into 0.2 whole square into cos theta. Theta is given as 60 degree. So cos 60 degree. So pi and pi will cancel out. It will be 0.2 into 0.2 cos 60 degree will be 1 by 2. So this comes out to be 0.02 Weber. So the correct option is A. Question number 15. As a result of change in the magnetic flux linked to the closed loop shown in the figure, an EMF V volt is induced in the loop. Okay. The work done in taking a charge Q coulomb once along the loop is. So how do we calculate the work done? So work done is equal to Q into V, where V is the EMF, or you could have written it like this, Q into integration of E dot dr, because the gradient of the potential difference is equal to electric field, right? Now we know that electric fields induced by moving charges, in general, they are non-conservative. Now what do we mean by non-conservative? Non-conservative means that here the work done does not depend on the initial and final points, but also depend on the nature of the path that is being followed. So therefore, in this case, the work done will not be zero. Instead, it will be Q into V. That is option A. So why I gave that explanation is, many a times students would think that this is a closed loop. So since the initial point and the final point is the same, so the work done would be zero. But please remember that here work done is based on the induced EMF, and induced EMF in turn is dependent on the electric fields. And we know that electric fields which are induced by moving charges, they are non-conservative. So they just do not depend on initial and final points. They also depend on the nature of the path that is being followed. Question number 16. The magnetic flux through a circuit of resistance R changes by an amount delta phi in time delta t. Then the total quantity of electric charge Q that passes any point in the circuit during the time delta t is represented by. Okay, so we know that induced EMF is equal to delta phi by delta t for any time period delta t. And we also know that induced EMF is equal to induced current into resistance. Right? So current can be written as induced EMF by resistance, that is 1 by R into delta phi by delta t. Now, current is also the rate of change of charges flowing per unit time. So delta Q by delta T, this is equal to 1 by R delta phi by delta T. So this is equal to delta Q is equal to 1 by R into delta phi. So the correct option is B. Question number 17. Two coils have mutual inductance of 0.005 Henry. The current changes in the first coil according to the equation I is equal to I naught sine omega t. I naught is equal to 10 amperes and omega is equal to 100 pi radian per second. The maximum value of EMF in the second coil is, okay, so we know that the phi is equal to MI. So if I is the current flowing in coil 1, then phi is the magnetic flux in coil 2 due to coil 1. So this can also be written as minus d phi by dt is equal to minus m di by dt, right? So this is equal to EMF, induced EMF, which is equal to minus m d by dt of, instead of I, we can write it as I naught sine omega t. So this can be written as minus m I naught omega cos omega t. Now we want the maximum value of EMF. For the EMF to be maximum, cos omega t must be equal to 1. That's because the maximum possible value of cos theta is 1. So therefore, maximum EMF will be equal to m I naught omega. That is equal to 0.005 into I naught is 10, omega is 100 pi. So this comes out to be 5 pi volts. So right option is B. Question number 18. The current in self-inductance L is equal to 40 millihenry is to be increased uniformly from 1 ampere to 11 ampere in 4 milliseconds. So here L is given. The change of current is also given, and in how much time, that is also given. So we know that EMF is equal to L di by dt. So I think we have deduced this a number of times before. So here L is given as 40 into 10 to the power minus 3 Henry. Now always take care of units. Many a times we do not take the correct units. We just assume that it is in Henry, but it is actually in millihenry. And di will be 11 minus 1. And time is 4 milliseconds again, so 4 into 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. So these will get cancelled. So this is 40 into 10 divided by 4. So this is equal to 100 volts. Option A.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.